Catalan really wants to put pressure on his opponent here tonight. He doesn't want Young to get comfortable, start to develop into a sound off stance. He wants to utilize the kicks and really control the distance with it, of this fight.
Aggressive start by Catalan. He's got that square on stance, hasn't he? Southpaw, but with his body fairly square, much more so than Zhang, who gets caught with a kick to the chin there. The Chinese man took that one, and he's winding up that right arm, just loosening it up a little bit. And Catalan jumps in and pings the left hand. He's being really aggressive here, and Zhang's on the end of this.
Yeah, we're definitely seeing a new level of aggression coming from Catalan. I'm surprised he wants to take this fight to the ground, but he feels he's going to be more dominant on the ground, utilizing his newly discovered jiu-jitsu skills. He's been spending a lot of time in Manila working on his ground game.
Short.
BJJ was one of the first things that Zhang picked up after he progressed from simply kickboxing. So they may both be fairly keen to try things out here.
See here that Catalan's kind of working almost in Young's butterfly guard, a butterfly half guard, where he's kind of elevating one leg there. He's almost got fully passed, but he's kind of cradled him, so he's got his head and his leg kind of in a wrestling pin position. You can see the foot's kind of stuck in the cage a little bit there.
Mm, trying to just grab hold of it with his toes, isn't he? Which is why Olivier Coste gave it a bit of a slap. You're not allowed to grip the cage with hands or feet.
Yeah, I don't think he's doing that, you know, as an intent to try to break the rules. I think he's trying to push off. You can see he's trying to roll over onto his recover guard, which he's kind of lost it. And now Catalan's in full mount. This is not a good place for Zhang to be. He's got to let go of that grip and start pushing away.
Both of these men really quite desperate to get into the win column here.
Young's got to be careful. He's going to give up an arm bar possibly here if he keeps extending that left arm, but he manages to work his way out. Now we're in a north-south position, and Young's kind of going with that defense of grabbing hold of Catalan, so Catalan's not able to posture up and start dropping some ground and pound. Nice body shots there from Catalan.
Takes a few left hands to the face, Young as well.
Zhang gave up his back there, but he seemed okay. Nice little sacrifice throw for Catalan to get this fight back down to the ground. Catalan's really controlling Zhang well. He's posturing up, he's dropping the occasional shot in, delivering elbows and short right hands, just as a way to score points and let them know the judges that he's keeping active.
Just comes straight back at him, doesn't he? Gets pushed away by Zhang, but Catalan is very, very aggressive in this contest. And I think, as you said, Mitch, more so than perhaps we've seen him before. Just under 2 minutes left in the opening round.
Yeah, he definitely feels the urgency of this situation. He knows what a win in the ONE Championship cage will do for his career. And his family has had a bit of a rough go in it, but he feels that tonight is his night. Good control from the side control.
He's the oldest sibling, I think, of all of them, Mitch. Certainly the oldest fighter.
Yeah, he feels he needs to set the example for his family. He needs to prove that it can be done, and his family's style of martial arts can really be successful in a mixed martial arts cage.
And they all do look up to him.
Nice takedown there by Catalan. He's really shown improved grappling here.
Hammer blows with the left hand. He's got to be careful not to hit the back of the head, not come close to it there, but if he turns his head away, Zhang, then it could be seen as an illegal blow.
Stepped over nicely into the arm bar, but Zhang's protecting well. He's got that grip nice and tight. He's got both hands locked around. It's kind of a battle of attrition here. Let's see who can actually pry open either the defense or the submission.
What's going on with that right arm, Mitch? Is that? Oh, that's okay. It's all folded up. That's okay. Had it been extended, he would have been in trouble. Couldn't quite see there.
Yeah, I think Catalan is letting Olivier Coste know that those knees might have landed on the back of his head.
Knees okay. Knees allowed.
Well, you might have heard Olivier Coste just clarifying that knees to the head are allowed. But as you implied, Mitch, anything that lands behind at the back of the head between the ears without touching the ears, that's deemed an illegal blow.
The
and there's an example of what I think Rene Catalan is complaining about.
Yeah, Catalan kind of gave up position by raising his hand, trying to signal to the referee that one of those strikes landed in the wrong position. But now we can see that Edward Foliang is in his corner, and with big right hand, left hand coming there from the Superman punch from Catalan. There's that aggressive style of stand-up that we've seen in the early part of this round. And here's some more of that ground control we spoke of earlier. He passed nicely into the full mount and really just had a dominant display of ground and pound and grappling showed by Rene Catalan. Let's pull Rich Franklin here and see how he has that first round scored.
Well, at this point in time, Rene Catalan is running away with this fight. He's systematically come out very aggressive, earned himself several takedowns, controlled on the ground most of the time. There was a little period there where Jung was on top, able to do a little bit of damage. But even at the beginning of the round, he still had some striking superiority. And he's starting to accumulate some damage. And he's basically working his way up the ranks of the scoring criteria. So at this point, if the fight was stopped, there's no doubt that Catalan will get the decision.
Little mark underneath Zhang's right eye. You might have noticed there, we certainly could hear that Catalan did not choose to sit on his stool between rounds there. He sat on the deck with his legs split in the front splits position. Obviously feels that he gets more of a release in that way. Stretches out those hamstrings and the inner thighs. Oh, an aggressive kick to the lower leg from Zhang there. Kind of blow that can do a lot of damage if it buckles that knee inwards.
See, Catalan's keeping that hand, that right hand, nice and high to protect against that left hook. In some of the past footage, we've seen Zhang really unload that left hook really nicely and time it quite well.
He's much the taller man, isn't he? You figure if he can just time his approach in well, he could have some success here. And he really dove in with the right hand, with his head down as he did it. And he keeps shaking that right hand. It seems to me he's trying to loosen it rather than showboat.
But, yeah, he has a substantial height and reach advantage here. But he's not really utilizing the jab the way that he should to set up some of these other strikes. If he was just to throw that jab out a little bit more, he'd be able to find his distance a little bit quicker.
Catalan certainly got that bigger, thicker body. More. Oh, he's done well with the takedown there. And I was just about to say that Zhang's got to be very careful going inside because Catalan looks the stronger man.
Zhang attempted a flying knee there, but he didn't quite commit to it. And Catalan was able to tie him up and take him back down to the floor. Now, Zhang's attempting to possibly set up a triangle here. He's trying to control the hand, but he doesn't quite. Now he has it. Now he has one hand in, one hand out, and that's the wrong spot for Catalan to be in. You always want to have either both hands in or both hands outside of their legs. You never want to have one hand in because you're basically just giving your opponent a submission. Zhang's trying to work to that side, possibly looking for a kimura, or maybe trying to sneak that right arm under the neck of Catalan for an attempt at a guillotine. But he's keeping his guard nice and active, and oh, Catalan drops down into possibly
a
Achilles lock.
Of some sort, yeah.
Zhang's doing the right thing, but he might end up in a knee bar now. Ah, but he pops his way out.
Yeah. Slipped out of it. Their body's starting to get a little bit moist now with the sweat and the water that might have been splashed on them between rounds one and two. Difficult to get a purchase on that. Rich, do you score anything for that kind of maneuver, those attempted leg locks?
I make note of them, but Zhang wasn't in any kind of trouble or close to tapping out or anything like that. But the fact that Rene is actually going for submissions, attempting things, and trying to unfold a game plan. It's the same as being on the feet and actually throwing punches. You're trying to make something happen.
Does that trump submission defense then? When you're trying to go for things but not quite pulling them off?
Well, I guess possibly in a sense it does, because I really don't award submission defense. Like, I don't award Zhang a submission defense there because he didn't have to do much to defend the submission since it wasn't in that deep. So in order to actually score on a submission defense, you have to be kind of tight in some sort of hold and work your way out of that.
Right. We'll come back to Rich at the end of this round if we get that far and see how he scores it so far. But clearly, Catalan in the lead after the first 5 minutes. One championship rules dictate that judges score the fight in its entirety and not round by round. So we don't close the books after the end of each round. We look at the whole 15 minutes to see which fighter's on top. Three judges at cage side here at Stadium Negara in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia.
You can see here that Catalan's managed to work his way into the full mount, but Zhang's sort of defense is not really to let go and push away, which is usually a common technique. He's trying to keep Catalan close to avoid any sort of ground and pound. And if Catalan could just step over that arm, there could be a possible arm bar. He might be setting up a head and arm choke here. But it's, you know, it's interesting to see a world champion Wushu fighter and a Sanda fighter from China engaging in a pretty technical ground battle
where
they've been exchanging leg locks and attempting submissions. But you can just see the strength of Rene Catalan as he's just overwhelming Zhang in this mounted position.
Well, if he gets close enough, then he can land the heavier blows, can't he? Which is why you figure that Zhang really wants to be standing up and probably fighting from distance, despite the fact that he's developed some BJJ skills.
Well, now he's got his hand slightly under the neck, though. I don't know how deep it is, but it's a little bit under the chin there. He's got the rear naked choke.
Looks like it's on the chin to me, Mitch. I'm not sure that it's... It could be cranking his head quite badly there, but... they've just adjusted again slightly, and who knows where that arm is now.
Yeah, he was able to tough it out, but when it comes across the chin like that, we have seen people squeeze from both sides really tight.
Good punches.
Now he's unloading some ground and pound here.
Yeah, good punches from Catalan. They're all legal, either on the ear or to the front of the face. And Zhang there in the last 20 seconds took a good 15 or 16 blows to the side of the head and full on the face. And that will, you can see there, is a little bit wobbly as he goes back to the cage. Not quite clear where he is, actually. Has to be helped back to his corner.
There's that attempt at a flying knee, Steve. He jumps in, he tries the flying knee. It looks like it landed a little bit on the chin there. Rene was able to keep his wits about him and drag this fight down to the ground. And that's just pretty much been the entire story of that, between the 6 minute and that, the 10 minute mark of this fight has been the ground control of Rene Catalan. If we take it over to Rich Franklin, how'd you break down that fight, Rich?
I'll tell you what, you could look at the graphics and you can see that Rene came out aggressive, earned some more takedowns, increased his lead on the ground control. There was a bit of time at the beginning where they were throwing kicks back and forth. I think Rene landed the heavier strikes and again, increased his lead in the striking category, the striking superiority. Mounted some damage, he's just running away with the categories. And to answer your question, Steve, that last submission attempt by Rene with the rear naked choke, like I score Rene for a near submission there, I still give Zhang some points for actually wiggling his way out of it.
Yeah, exactly, yeah, I see.
Back, fighters back, thank you.
I tell you what though, as we went to replay, it was quite noticeable that Olivier Coste had to assist Zhang in finding his way to his stool because he was quite a bit dazed there after those blows that he took to the side and front of the face in that ground and pound position. So he's had a minute to just shake his head and gather his thoughts and his senses. And that is a thunderous kick to the side of the body into the back from Rene Catalan. Now he started the fight with his leading with his right hand. Now he's leading with his left hand and left leg, not quite as square on as he was at the beginning of the contest. But when he unleashes with these kicks, you get the very strong impression that they are solid.
Yes,
oh, mind you, how about that?
Zhang landed a nice leg kick there, but he's really kind of standing at that kicking range of Catalan. He's really got to try to cut the angle and start moving a little bit because he's just standing there like a, you know, just a punching bag right in his range where he can just unload some of these kicks. And when you have a world champion Wushu fighter throwing these heavy legs at you, you know, you got to start moving.
So he's got to make better use of his really sizable height and reach advantage, hasn't he? Find a way to make that work for him.
The only punch he's really thrown is that left hook. I'd like to see him. There he goes trying to step out the jab, but he telegraphed it, and Rene was able to just slide right out of the way. He's really got to change something drastically in these next, you know, 3 minutes or so if he wants to. I mean, possibly a near finish. But, Rich, if he is able to, you know, secure a near finish, is he able to win the fight?
At this point in time, I don't believe so. I think he's, on my scorecards, Rene's done enough at this point in time that if Zhang wants to win this fight, he's probably going to have to stop him, a submission or a knockout. Because even a near submission or a knockdown, if Rene survives that, you got to remember that Rene's already had one near finish himself.
At this point, they're just trading leg kicks.
I still get the feeling Zhang is a little bit wobbly from the attack he took towards the end of the second round, but he's got a decent left kick. That Catalan left leg is going to be fairly red and sore tonight.
Yeah, he's definitely landed some effective leg strikes, and that's really the only thing that he's doing right in this fight. If he was able to put some punches together with that leg kick, he could possibly do more damage. But he's just not really, he's a little bit gun shy at this point because I don't think he wants to go back down to the ground and get dominated for the rest of this fight.
You could see him looking for that left hook, Rene Catalan, and you just wanted to jump in, just one little step in and then unleash it to the head. And it almost paid off for him. He's got it poised there, a bit like a snake about to pounce.
See Catalan trying to figure out the distance, but a nice counter there, right? Yeah. As he's about to throw that leg, Rene Catalan throws that straight right hand and then follows it up with a hook.
Very snappy counters he's got, Catalan. Standing him in very good stead at the moment. 2 minutes left in this third and final round, and it's looking like Rene Catalan all the way. We just haven't seen enough from Zhang in terms of making use of those physical advantages he has. Considerably taller, as it's quite easy to see. This is a contest in the strawweight division.
Nice little catch from the leg kick there. He just went to the well one too many times. Rene was now able to drag this fight back down to the ground.
But that lower center of gravity, Mitch, really just once he got a hold of him, just bullied him into the cage side and then down to the ground, didn't he?
Yeah, that's where the strength comes in. Able to rush him and just tease that. And that's been the story of this the fight pretty much, is that Rene Catalan has been able to control this fight when it does get to the clinch, and then ultimately as he is able to secure the takedown. And he's just been able to show dominant control on the ground, which has really shown his improved areas, because Rene Catalan has had problems on the ground in previous fights. But this new weight, now that he's come down to straw weight, you know, now he's fighting at a little bit more comfortable weight for himself, and he had to go up a few times, and actually had to try to gain weight to fight some of his previous opponents. This straw weight division is just a good place for him to be right now.
Wouldn't that be nice, trying to eat to gain weight? I could do that.
It's really nice not to have a weight cut here at ONE Championships. It makes such a difference, especially when you're getting into the later rounds, to not have to cut weight, not have to dehydrate yourself.
I haven't encountered a fighter who's against it. They're all for it.
Yeah, it completely changes the fight game, and it really makes the last week of a fight, you know, a tremendously different experience.
Concentrate on the fight. Concentrate on your conditioning rather than just simply losing weight. Catalan, good punches to the side of the body there, and that's always been this weak area for the taller man. You attack the body, the big tree will come down. That's what Catalan's doing there on the ground. 10 seconds left in this contest. Certainly in the view of Rich Franklin, or at least at the 10-minute stage, he was well ahead. And as we got into the early part of this round as well, and it looks as if Rene Catalan is going to get his first professional win here in Kuala Lumpur. A mark in the win column would be gratefully received by him. It's all about to be confirmed by our three judges at cage side. As we have a look at the fight in its entirety here, Mitch, it was Catalan from the off, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was his only strength that he was able to land those leg kicks. But Catalan kind of figured it out, caught the leg kick, dragged this fight to the ground, and was able to finish in dominant fashion. Rich, do you agree? Is it anything changed for you in that last round?
No, I think it's pretty obvious to the fans watching that Rene has got that fight decision. So I've disagreed with the judges a couple times in my life, but this one can't be.
The official decision with Anthony Suntai.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision. From the red corner, Rene, the challenger, Catalan!
And in the multicolored, predominantly dark shorts, it's Matthijs.
Matthijs is definitely taking his time, easing into the striking exchange with the Wusu world champion. Catalan looks very relaxed, almost smirking at Matthijs. Oh, but he goes in right for a nice little body clinch takedown.
And he did that amid some brutal punches that were coming towards his head there from the Indonesian.
You can see Matthijs trying to go with the headlock, but you can just see Rene Catalan, his art striker, starts to slightly take his back, but he ends up in side control now.
Catalan, the man who late in his career voicing ambitions to challenge for the world title.
Now we definitely see the improved wrestling from Catalan, but look at that. Nice belly to back takedown, almost a suplex.
High intensity start to this contest. And more takedowns.
Yeah, we're seeing a very improved skill set from Catalan. He's using a body clinch to execute some very impressive suplex takedowns. Now he's got side control, delivers a little bit of ground and pound, pins the arm down. Now he's got Matisse's arm trapped in between his legs. He's dropping a little bit of ground and pound. Matisse just stands right back up.
Does well to get up as well. He was taking some good left hands to the head. Another suplex that goes down, belly to back this time. And he's got that left arm around the mouth of the Indonesian. It gets pulled a little bit lower around the chin, but well in control of it so far, Adrian Matisse, looking to fend off the threat of a rear naked choke.
Now he sinks in the hooks as he takes his Matisse's back. Now Matisse has got to protect his neck by controlling that left hand of Catalan.
Matisse getting plenty of support from the fans here at the Jakarta Convention Center.
Matisse is doing the right thing. He's defending that rear naked choke by preventing that hand from lacing around his neck. But you can see that Catalan now, he's got a face crank into a rear naked choke. Let's see if he can slide that arm underneath the chin there of Matisse.
That face is moved to the left, isn't it, as well? Does that put even more torque on Mitch on that crank?
Yeah, it cranks the neck. It's, you know, a face crank. It's going to be extremely painful, but most fighters can grit it out. They can tough it out. And Matisse is a very tough kid.
Half time, half game.
He's got both hands on that.
Keep working, keep working.
To try and fend it off again.
Yeah, he can't let those hands go. He's got to continue to hand fight. Now he's got one leg laced out, so if he can just slide his hips out. Oh, but Catalan did the right thing by ending up on top there. Matisse again scrambles out of it.
And they're both back to their feet and down they go again.
Now there's a possible arm triangle being set up here by Catalan. You can see Matisse has got to answer the phone. He's got to bring that right hand up to the side of his head. He's not defending it correctly.
Catalan scooting round to try and get more purchase on that, but Matisse is following him in this clockwise direction.
Catalan's got it kind of in a headlock choke, not really a full arm triangle, but it's definitely painful. But Matisse does the right thing by getting that arm away from his head. But just the improved wrestling and the grappling of Catalan, where he's able to maintain position and stay on top.
No rest for the wicked in this one. Very high intensity from the start as we are just about to enter the fifth and final minute of this opening round, scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Judges will score this one in its entirety. The full 15 minutes, not round by round.
Matisse is making a critical error. He's trying to turn to the opposite side. He should be turning away from Catalan so he can get his hips out. See how he's turning his hips into Catalan? That's the wrong way you want to go. He wants to be going the other way so he can create some distance from Catalan.
Now Catalan working the forearm as well onto that face of Matisse. Elbow and forearm can be such a dangerous weapon. A lot of problems for the Indonesian to deal with here. And now come the blows left and right.
He was able to power out of that headlock, maintain a little bit of posture, spins into an armbar. Matisse, he's turning the arm out. He's doing the right thing. He's trying to roll. He's got to move. He's got to move. Catalan's not letting it go. I don't think Matisse is going to tap here in his hometown. He grits out the round, Steve.
Good job. He probably knew that the bell was only moments away. His body movement was quite correct in trying to minimize the impact, but the time was on his side.
Here was that early exchange, and this was pretty much the only stand-up that we saw. The Wushu expert chooses to take this fight to the ground, and here's that big suplex takedown, beautifully done. Let's go to Rich Franklin and get his view on that round.
I'll tell you, this round was all about the takedowns, and the fans would see a lot of the takedowns in this round, but I honestly didn't score as many takedowns as you would think, because once Rene had scored that first takedown in the round, The rest of it for me was just a scramble. They were back up and back down again, back up and back down. So I scored him with three legitimate takedowns in that round, and then I also gave him points in the ground control category. At this point in time, clearly the fans should be able to tell that this is a fight that Rene Catalan has completely in control.
So it's what you do with the takedown, not just the fact that you can bring it on.
Well, once he hits the takedown, Mateus is doing a great job of scrambling. He was mounted, he's bucking his hips, he's doing everything he needs to do to keep himself out of big, big trouble. But once they get back to their feet and then hit the ground again and get back to their feet, like if they're just quick scrambles, I will score that differently than just three separate takedowns.
What about the attempted submission?
Oh, I definitely have a close rear naked choke, and that armbar at the end will definitely be a near sub for me in my scoring.
Something of a slower start to this second round, and you can't really blame them. They were very, very busy, weren't they, in that first 5 minutes?
Yeah, Mateus was just out-grappled in that round, and he does not want to go into the ground again because he's just overpowered by the Filipino fighter. So he's got to try to keep his distance, maybe not throw kicks, use those hands, and start moving around a little bit more to keep this fight on his feet.
Undoubtedly, he would have had a little bit of education from his corner, Mateus, to try and stay away from those dangerous areas that you pointed out, Mitch. A little bit more caution from the Indonesian now, with the crowd very much on his side. What can he do here in the stand-up?
See, he's got to circle out. He can't keep rushing forward like that because immediately Rene slid under the punches and was able to secure that single leg and drag him back down to the ground. He's got to enter these exchanges and then leave them. He can't stay flat-footed in the pocket like that. He's going to leave himself open for these takedowns.
Don't forget, in his two tournament wins in the strawweight division, Mateus scored victories with an average of under a minute each, so he's really in unknown territory here, not only into the seventh minute of this contest, but into the second round. Never been there before, and now he's got to deal with Catalan's knees to the head if it wasn't bad enough already for him.
Some good side control position here. He's trying to lock the arms down, making sure he's not able to really move. He's got good hip position. He's able to drop a little bit of elbows just to stay active enough so that the referee doesn't stand him back up. Now he's sliding in north-south position. And it looks like he's attacking
another armbar attempt.
This one's a little bit deeper. He's going under the armpit there, so he locks him into position, and he is just cranking on that arm, and Yuji Shimada has had enough.
Could well have been a verbal submission. There was no tap that I could see, but no argument either from Adrian Mateus.
Yeah, Yuji just pointed to himself and said, yeah, I think I'm the one that stopped that. I don't think he wanted to damage the joint. Like I said before, I do not think Mateus was going to tap in his home country.
Yeah, well, that's fair enough. And good refereeing in that case from Yuji Shimada. And as I said, no complaints whatsoever from the Indonesian. Let's take another look.
See, he could have tapped very easily here, but look at this. Rene sunk that arm. He locked it underneath the elbow and was just completely hyperextending. And if Yuji Shimada did not stop that fight, I think it possibly could have been the end of that elbow joint right there.
It's that third phase there, yeah. Isn't it, Mitch, that really caused the trouble. And full credit to Yuji Shimada for calling that one on the Indonesian fighter's behalf. With the official decision is Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 2 minutes and 8 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of armbar, Rene Catalan!
Here we go, 3 5-minute rounds, and look at the very cagey Buho Yuga.
Buho Yuga immediately threatens that slow lower stance, possibly hinting that he's going to go for a takedown, but Catalan comes out with a hammer on the left hand.
Straight left cross down the tube early from the southpaw. Catalan, he's opened up like a house on fire. You see Buho Yuga trying to control the posture of Rene Catalan, who has exploded here with the ground and pound right out of the gate.
He's got to be careful. Buho Yuga might be hurt, but he might blow himself out. So he's got to slow down, keep the pace. You can see Buho Yuga clinching nice and tight to eliminate some of the possible damage.
Catalan tries to pass, now tries to get a full mount on the Chinese martial artist. Puts him inside of half guard, though. Good work there from Buho Yuga.
Buho Yuga nice step over there from Catalan as Buho Yuga just powers out of the mount position.
Upper body strength there from Buho Yuga, the Greco-Roman stylist, top position for him now. What an exciting opening minute to their very first contest on ONE Championship, Quest for Greatness. Beautiful elbow to the clavicle there off his back from Rene Catalan.
That's smart defense by Buhuyoga to slow down the onslaught from Catalan. Reverse the position. Now this is where he really excels. When he gets on that top position, that wrestling takes over, and he's so dominant from the top.
1 foot on hip here from Rene Catalan. He'll use that to create space between him and Buhuyoga. Buhuyoga wants to get those hands free and work the ground and pound that was so effective for Catalan earlier on. Catalan looking for an arm now to no avail and takes a hammer fist strike between the eyes.
Nice little submission attempt there, Buhuyoga. You can see that Buhuyoga is not that quite, he hasn't really gotten too comfortable yet in blending Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu with his high level wrestling, because he did exactly the right thing by keeping that elbow away from the crotch of Catalan, but he passes nicely into side control.
Buhuyoga predicted he'd win by ground and pound in the very first round. Catalan didn't predict a round, but he said he would knock out the Chinese martial artist. Side control here for Buhuyoga.
We almost had that knockout in the very first couple seconds of this contest.
Elbows to the ribs there from Buhuyoga. They're reverse elbows. No going for neon belly here from the Chinese athlete. Catalan got to find a way to get out of this predicament. And looking for a choke here is Buhuyoga turning like a clock.
He's getting nice and tight in that north-south choke. He's starting to squeeze, but Catalan gives us the thumbs up, says that he's okay.
You see Catalan turning with Buhuyoga, defending against this choke attempt. Great view there of the attempted submission from the Chinese, and nice reversal from Rene Catalan. Crowd responds.
Beautifully done by Rene Catalan to bridge out of that, using some of Buhuyoga's medicine against him to get the turn of offense just like that. Now Catalan's on top. He's trying to slide that knee over onto belly, but he's comfortable just to stay here inside control.
Catalan, of course, a wushu stylist. Wushu resembles kickboxing and Muay Thai, but does allow for more grappling techniques. He's one of the best wushu martial art competitors of the last 15 years. He's won every title conceivable in wushu, Rene Catalan.
You can see he's trying to pin down the arm, but a good move by Buhuyoga to get back into full guard.
It is fantastic ground game from both of these men in the opening round. Body shots now, then the right hand to the head from Rene Catalan. That was rapid fire from the Filipino. Wades in with the left hand again, and Buhuyoga throws the hands around the neck and pulls him down to control that posture. He doesn't want the ground and pound raining down on him, Mitch.
Yeah, but Rene's doing the right stuff. He's posturing up, creating a little bit of space, flurrying with the punches, and then getting nice and tight to take a little bit of a break. Buhuyoga, now he's got him in half guard. Let's see if Rene tries to pass into full mount, possibly side control.
We are seeing a dazzling display on the ground from both of these warriors. Tremendous opening stance, a set for three, last 25 seconds of the first round.
Just that right knee is the only thing preventing Catalan from fully passing into side control. It looks like we're gonna see a second round here.
So the prediction of Buhuyoga for a ground and pound TKO in the first will not happen. We're about to go to the towels and move in to the second round. It was an absolute ripper of a first, where Rene Catalan opened up like a house on fire and finished up in dominant side control.
Beautiful, look at this. Watch this left hand, boom, straight down the middle, puts Buhuyoga on the canvas and immediately starts to swarm. Perfectly timed, the leg kick was coming right down the middle with the left hand. Then he immediately swarmed on him, tried to finish the fight, but here's that reversal to get Buhuyoga, ends up on top. And then we've seen that north-south choke that he tried to get tight, not quite the right position. Catalan gives us the thumbs up. Rich Franklin, how'd you see it?
Well, interestingly enough, on that replay of the left hand, I didn't score that on striking superiority. I actually scored it on damage. You can see the graph here. I have Catalan win in the damage category, both on internal damage there because he knocked him down, as well as some superficial damage with the blood to the nose. There was also a bit on the ground. There was some scoring in the ground control category, but both these guys, they spent time on top, time in superior position and with the ground and pound. So I have them about even, maybe Catalan actually edging out that category. At this point in time, I have Catalan ahead on the scorecards.
Second round, set for three. Let's see if Catalan will try and keep the contest on its feet for a while here. He's in the southpaw stance and the red trunks. Puho Yuga will switch stance between southpaw and orthodox. You see there, he went from southpaw back to his, I guess, preferred orthodox stance, really. Depends what he's trying to throw here.
Yeah, Puho Yuga said he spent a lot of time working on his boxing, but he doesn't want to show any of it. Immediately shooting in for the double leg takedown. Now Catalan's again on his back, immediately throwing the elbows.
Catalan had some good success in the opening round, throwing the elbows to the deltoid region of Puho Yuga.
I like how active Catalan's being. Immediately, as soon as he hits the ground, not wasting any time, keeps him in full guard, but starts throwing the elbows. Look at that. Really well done, really active from the bottom position. Just because you're on top does not mean you are controlling this fight. Looks like he's trying to pin down these arms, possibly might throw up another arm bar like he tried in the first.
Nice downward elbow again there from Catalan. You see Puho Yuga trying to pass, and Catalan puts him back inside the guard. Butterfly hook on the right leg of Puho Yuga. 1 foot on hips on the other leg.
Watch out the head.
Looking for the elbow again to that shoulder region is Rene Catalan. Double feet on hips now, can make some room to move here, Rene Catalan.
See, even though Puho Yuga is on top and it seems like he's controlling the position, you have to look at how active Catalan's being. He's controlling the grips, not letting Puho Yuga get into a dominant position, controlling the head, controlling the posture, and delivering those elbows from all sorts of positions.
Both men coming in on streaks tonight. Puho Yuga winning his last three. Rene Catalan on back-to-back wins. Who will keep the streak alive after tonight? Puho Yuga wants to try and pass here and go to the side of the body of Rene Catalan. Catalan won't allow that. Olivier Coste right on top of the action as always. What's Puho Yuga looking to do here, Mitch?
He's trying to get into the right position to possibly throw some ground and pound, but you can just see him, he's not really even punching. The only thing he's doing is trying to control that position, grab the head, get into a stronger position. That natural reaction to do what you've spent your life doing, which is wrestling, is his inclination. And now Catalan has swept him to end up on top.
Top position for Rene Catalan. This fight has been 99% a ground battle so far. But what a contest. It really is back and forth seesawing action. One man takes the top, the other man reverses it, and both get off some salvos.
Yeah, see, now Catalan, you can see him starting to drop a little bit of that ground pound, but nice sweep there. Now both these fighters have had the chance, the opportunity to throw up a possible heel hook or leg lock, but they're not really going after the legs. So you can see Puho Yuga trying to interlock that leg to hold him in position, but Catalan's just trying to muscle his way up on top.
Oh, nice aggressive left hands, the neon belly from Rene Catalan. Now dominant ground and pound from the Filipino. And Puho Yuga won't let him out. Locks onto him again, does the very strong Chinese athlete, that tremendous upper body strength of the Greco-Roman wrestling champion.
Nice scrambles by both athletes. They're like you said, Michael, they're constantly moving, constantly going back and forth into position.
Mitch, you talk about strength in mixed martial arts, and Greco-Roman wrestlers for upper body strength have to be right at the top of the pecking order.
And you can just see in a lot of these positions, he's using that upper body clinch to just sort of control the movements of Catalan, but Catalan is scrambling in there, and it's showing the time that he has been putting into the grappling department of his training.
Catalan has had an opportunity so far to test a little of that Sambo that, as I said earlier, he won a gold medal in earlier this year, the Russian martial art of Sambo. One butterfly hook, one foot on hips here from Catalan, still dropping those elbows to the head now of Puho Yuga. Puho Yuga looks to posture up and work that left hand. Under 30 seconds remaining. And very much a swinging battle between these two athletes. Nice tagging left hand there from Buhwao Yugaraji, postured up momentarily.
But look at the way that Catalan is deflecting that right hand. Buhu Yoga's got a big looping left hand for the grounding pound, and Catalan's just sliding his right hand up, and the hand is just grazing off. Just like that, he just barely missed, and he's able to transition into a beautiful armbar.
Hoping to go kleptomaniac and steal the round with a final second submission attempt. We've got one round to go in this thrilling contest.
But again, Michael, you can't steal the round. The fight is judged in its entirety. Here's a little bit of that ground and pound back and forth from both athletes. There's Catalan just unleashing that left hand, but good defense by Buhu Yoga. Rich, how did you break that one down?
Well, I like looking at that replay right there because it tells the story. Catalan was doing a good job actually on the ground, whether he was on bottom or the top, of controlling the action. He was doing a good job with his ground and pound with elbows to the top of the head when he was in guard, and he was landing effective ground and pound from the topside position. Some of that for me actually scores in the ground control category. Some of it's starting to creep its way into the damage category as well. I also awarded Rene Catalan at the end of the round there a near submission for that armbar because that last armbar looked like it was in deep. So he's now scored in the highest category for us as well. He's increased his lead in this second round.
Mitch, if you're in the corner of Buhwao Yuga, what are you telling the Chinese athlete to do in the third and final round?
He's got to be more active once he gets on top. Catalan is actually outstriking him when he's in the bottom position. He's got to let those hands go from the top position when he gets in there and not just wrestle and try to control the position.
On the back foot early here, Buhwao Yuga of China. Switching stance again between Southpaw and Orthodox is Buhwao Yuga.
The percentages say that Buhu Yoga is probably going to attempt a double leg takedown very soon and not want to stand with the Wushu World Champion. But once he gets on top, he's got to let those hands go.
And that's what Catalan just did, an almost connected flush with that right hand, aimed for the jaw of Buhwao Yuga. Catalan not rushing anything, taking his time, looking for the opening. Oh, big overhand right there from Buhwao Yuga.
Here's some of this boxing that Buhwao Yuga said he wanted to do. He wanted to stand, and he wanted to show us a new dimension of his game. That takedown has got to be coming from anywhere, though. Oh, he didn't like that. He got tagged with a left hand there, and he kind of winced away a little bit.
Let's see if the 2 months spent in Harbin in northeastern China, tightening up his striking skills, pays off in this final round for Buhwao Yuga. Southpaw stance now on Catalan, goes for an outside thigh kick, connects with it. Just dropping that shin to the top of the thigh in the quadriceps region, and another one there from Rene Catalan. The more that he continues to kick the legs of Buhwao Yuga, the harder it will be for the Greco-Roman wrestler to shoot in and take down Rene Catalan.
Man, everything Catalan does is so fast. It's that wushu style striking that they've got from the Philippines. There's a double leg, but a good defense there to get that underhook and pry Buhwao Yuga back up to his feet and not able to stop the takedown.
Buhwao Yuga will look back at that one and think he should have committed to that takedown attempt a little more. It's a little sloppy on the execution. Drills a knee to the midsection of Rene Catalan, tries for a short left hand to the ribs. Can Buhwao Yuga put Rene Catalan on his back as we approach the halfway point of this third and final round?
Just like, see now, I mean, you can see that Rene Catalan was able to get double underhooks, and then he was able to get Buhwao Yuga out and actually now start to control the clinch and delivers a knee.
Terrific takedown defense from Rene Catalan. Still stays vertical here against Buhwao Yuga, which is saying something for a man of Buhwao Yuga's wrestling pedigree.
That's the time that he has spent working on that wrestling defense and his own wrestling out there in Makati, Manila, with Catalan Fighting Systems.
Catalan, who told us yesterday he hadn't seen much video footage on Buhwao Yuga, didn't know quite what to expect here today. Now he has top position inside of half guard.
Good hips by Catalan to stop the takedown and end up on top. Now he's in the half guard, easily passes over almost into full mount, just like that. Now he's in full mount.
The now most dominant position he's been in so far in this contest, Mitch. Full mount for Rene Catalan. 1 minute 30 remaining.
If he postures up, he could let some hands rain down.
It's a very high mount here from Catalan. He could even swing over and hope for an armbar on Buho Yuga. Would be something to slap an armbar on those momentous arms of the Chinese athlete.
This is his chance. What? I'm sure his corner is screaming at him to posture. Buho Yuga's giving up his back.
Could be danger here for Buho Yuga. Catalan has his back, but Buho Yuga out of trouble, gets into top position inside of Catalan's guard. 1 minute remaining. Can Buho Yuga do some damage with the ground and pound?
Bit high on that when he had the back and he's barely slipped off. Could have went for an arm bar, but he chose to let Buho Yuga control the top position, put him on his back. And this is where we might spend the last 41 seconds. I wonder if anything's going to change in these last couple seconds.
See how Catalan is locking up the right arm of Buho Yuga, foot on hips on the left side to keep the distance there. Get very good defense against the ground and pound from Rene Catalan.
He's got to be a bit more active. Both these fighters in the last 20 seconds, we need to let it all go. Catalan needs to get up.
Buho Yuga, is he going to invite Catalan up? No, he won't. Goes for a hammer fist strike instead. Looking to pass and go to side control. Gets there, the Chinese warrior. He gets him out now. Final seconds for Buho Yuga. Raining down the hammer fist strikes. Catalan gives his back, but time may be against Buho Yuga. And the bell sounds to end a tremendous contest.
Wow, how are the judges gonna see that last little bit of action there? Does it swing it in Buho Yuga's favor, or did Catalan do enough in the first 14 minutes and 50 seconds to secure the win? Look at this nice little knee. That was when he battled him off the cage, worked the right position in the underhooks. Here's the attempted takedown by Buho Yuga, but Catalan was able to get on top. And in the last 10 seconds, Buho Yuga was able to get on top, secure the mount, and let the punches rain down. Rich Franklin, what do you got?
Listen, you know, in my opinion, the last 10 seconds there where Rene had gone to back, it's not enough.
Let's go to Dominic Lau and find out who won this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Rene Catalan.
Tonight. It could potentially be the biggest night in Chinese martial arts history here in one championship, with Zhong Jingnan going for the world title in our main event. Early takedown here from Peng Shuwen.
Immediately, Catalan came out throwing the heat, but this guillotine looks kind of deep. Peng Shuwen's trying to adjust.
Peng Shuwen said he would submit Rene Catalan, said it would come early, looking for a guillotine from off of his back here.
Catalan's probably going to pop his head out. He looks to have enough space on the side. Yep, just like that.
Let's see if Catalan can posture up and work any ground and pound now. Catalan said he'll find a submission via the armbar, or he'll knock out Peng Shuwen in the third round. Certainly a rugged start for Rene Catalan.
Looks like there might have been kind of a push off to the groin maybe a little bit there in the guard, as he was trying to get back up, or at least create some space that he really pushed away on the groin.
Very young martial artist Peng Shuwen, as we said, can he get the momentum rolling for Team China tonight? Looking forward to seeing Zhong Jinnan in our main event. Should she win gold, she'll be the first ever Chinese athlete to do it here at One Championship. And there was a knee to the groin of Rene Catalan. So Catalan will be entitled to some recovery time here should he need it. A full 5 minutes is allotted for injury time. Let's take another look at the injury rules here at One Championship. An athlete is allowed 5 minutes for medical examination and recovery. Now, if Catalan is unable to continue in the allotted time, an official decision will be given. Catalan getting a moment to sit down. Peng Shuwen is not allowed to consult with his corner during this break. And you can see Olivier Coste just having words there with Peng Shuwen.
I was wrong. It wasn't a push-off. You can clearly see before this match went to the floor, you could see that he got caught with a knee. And that must have been that was at least a minute they were on the ground with that attempted guillotine to have that shot. Look at this. The clean groin strike right to the, yep.
I'd say accidental.
Accidental.
He was aiming for the bread basket and went a little too low there. Peng Shuwen.
You could see that, Catalan was definitely in distress there.
Olivier Coste just consulting with Catalan. Peng Shuwen is raring to go. And Catalan looks like he's okay. Right. But caught
ready.
In an attempted guillotine. The very start of this contest, Rene Catalan doesn't want to be back there. He wants to try and keep this contest standing, work his wushu. Lots of instructions coming from the corner of Peng Shuwen. Hooking punch from Catalan, will it take down? Will he try and step back and go to his feet? Or will he engage with Peng Shuwen on the ground? Indeed, he does just that.
Catalan throws so fast, his strikes come so quickly. And you can see Peng Shuwen is not used to being on his back. Wrestlers are typically more dominant from the top position. That's where they spend most of their time.
Push off there, feet on hips from Peng Shuwen. Catalan, southpaw stance, meaning he's fighting left-handed. Edges forward. What Peng Shuwen wants to do here is throw the right hand down the tube, keep his lead foot on the outside of Catalan's lead foot. Front kick from Catalan, big tough thumping hand, and he curls it over the top again, then goes to the midsection of Peng Shuwen.
He's coming in and out on these strikes. You can see he throws everything in each one of these shots, but then he's stepping back out of range, so Peng Shuwen can't counter.
Catalan would be wise to set up that overhand lift with a jab off the lead hand. Is a single punch. And Peng Shuwen, the youngster, displaying some patience here.
Like he was attacking the lead late, Michael. That's going to slow Peng Shuwen down later in the minutes of this match and possibly not be able to shoot as well.
Muay Thai clinch of the high knee from Peng Shuwen. Threads the right hand, forearm across the throat, gives up on that. Looking for a dominant clinch position here, Peng Shuwen. Short popping left hand from Rene Catalan. And Catalan shrugs off the Chinese athlete. Roundhouse kick from Peng Shuwen. High kick again off the back leg. Launches the right hand. Catalan saw it coming, took him down.
Gotta be surprised. Catalan's the one getting the dominant positions here in the scrambles. He's on top, now he's in north-south position. Peng Shuwen is not used to being on his back. He spent so much time training that wrestling style, Greco-Roman, national wrestling champion, used to be on top. Now you can see Catalan scooting around the back there. Peng Shuwen gets back up to his feet.
A tango back against the cage. Peng Shuwen, a chance to use the knees back. Olivier Coste just saying not to clinch the cage. Hope you're enjoying it. If you're watching live on Twitter, make sure you follow us at One Championship. Use the hashtag Kings of Curry. Tucked out attempt there from Peng Shuwen. And now the ground and pound from side control from Rene Catalan. Dominant position for Catalan. The back elbows.
Catalan trying to frame off the face there, drop a little bit of the elbows. We're seeing Catalan really control a lot of the scrambles in the clinch position.
If Catalan can lock on the submission he wants at the armbar, this is where he'll do it from. He's going for the sub. He's trying to take home the arm.
He's trying to go belly down. Oh, Peng Shuwen can't let go of that arm. He's trying to scramble out of it.
This would be amazing if Rene Catalan can sink a sub on Peng Shuwen in the first round.
He looks to be out of it now. We're just in scramble. Let's see if Rene Catalan can pop up out. Yup, he does.
Peng Shuwen throws up the legs. Catalan all over it. Half a strike from Catalan. Both heavy hands. Nicely done. Left hand to the jaw there from Catalan. Now back to his feet.
Catalan gave him a dominant position because he was maybe going for a leg lock there. He's back up to the feet, and this is where he wants it anyway.
Catalan now in orthodox stance, fighting right-handed. Edges forward, Catalan throws the outside leg kick, well placed. Been a very impressive round after the guillotine attempt early on from Peng Shuwen. It's been impressive for Rene Catalan, Mitch.
I gotta say, I'm a little bit surprised that Catalan has been winning the scrambles and ended up in a dominant position. Here's some of that heat thrown by both these gentlemen early in the first round. Look at the dominant control from Catalan as he jumps on top to drop a little bit of ground and pound. Here's the headlock takedown, but Rene Catalan kept his base, ended up on top. That was a good round for the Filipino, Michael.
The Chemwe camp of Rene Catalan paying dividends in the opening stanza. Catalan choosing to sit while Pinchot chooses to stand. Does that tell you anything about the condition of the mentality of either of these two athletes?
Sometimes it can play a little bit of mind games with your opponent. If you see him, they're not taking the stool, you can be like, ah, he's fresh. But you gotta remember, Peng Shui Wen is 18 years younger than Catalan. So, you know, it's okay for, you know, Catalan to sit down and take a little bit of a break.
Not to offend Catalan, but is there a thing in this sport, Mitch's old man strength?
There is definitely a thing called ready? Old man strength. He's been in there so many times. Two. He's been to so many battles. He has that physical strength. We've got Wushu versus wrestling here.
And it was Wushu prevailing in the opening round. The Wushu stylist Catalan in the black. The Greco-Roman wrestler Peng in the red. China versus the Philippines, wherever you're watching, around the world. We hope you're enjoying the first event of a huge 2018 for one championship, the home of martial arts. Roshan, face off here. The start of the second round. Catalan in the first, we saw him switch between southpaw and orthodox. He's opened up this round in orthodox. Jabbing now, Catalan. Overhand right from him. A nuggety, powerful martial artist.
I might see Peng Shuwen went change up his strategy. He's kind of just standing in front of him. There he goes. Now he gets to the takedown. Tried for a sidestep there. Didn't quite work, but he's able to get back up on top.
Catalan careful not to give up his back here. He's okay. Top position, looking for side control. Rene Catalan had it in the first round. Where can he go? What are the options from here, Mitch?
For Catalan, he's got a north-south choke, but it looks like Catalan, or Peng Shuwen Wen rather, is going to spin out of it. It looks like he's safe. He might try to posture up, do a little bit of ground and pound here.
Hammer fist strikes. Curled in knuckles there from Rene Catalan. Peng Shuwen Wen pressed against the cage. 1.5 minutes down in the second round. Ultra impressive from Catalan in the first round. Is Peng Shuwen trying to find a way back to his feet? One place a Greco-Roman wrestler doesn't want to be is on their back.
You can see he's a little bit uncomfortable being there. He doesn't quite know what to do when he's on his back. He's not keeping the distance. He needs to frame off, use the cage, get back up to his feet. I'd like to see him punch maybe into some takedowns. Give Catalan some different looks.
Does Catalan invite him up here, Mitch?
No, he's doing pretty well in this position. Maybe start hammering the legs a little bit. But he chose to duck his head down and dive into the guard. Now he could be in a triangle.
Triangle may be setting up here for Peng Shuwen. Could that have been a cardinal mistake by Catalan to have gone into the guard? The triangle locked on. He's going to try and pull the head down and cinch it up here. Catalan could be in trouble. Peng Shuwen, can he cinch it up? Triangle and Rene Catalan halfway through the second round.
As long as he keeps his arm on that side of the hip, he's going to be okay. It's going to be hard for Peng Shuwen Wen to finish. He has to try to move the arm to the other side and start to get a little bit higher up on the head and shoulder area there. But Catalan seems to be okay. We might try to slam his way out of this. Peng Shuwen Wen, let's go.
You wonder how much energy that took from the young martial artist from China. Big left hand through the guard there from Catalan. Up kick from Peng Shuwen. And kick to the knees. Peng Shuwen competing off his back at the moment. And Olivier Coast has gone up. Two. An intriguing contest in front of a sellout crowd inside Jakarta Convention Center.
Peng Shuwen Wen might be a little bit fatigued. He seems to be a little sluggish. There's no movement from him. He's just a stationary target standing right in front of Catalan. If Catalan can turn up the volume here, switch gears, and start to unload, he might be able to take it out.
The Filipino with a liver shot that hurt him! That hurt Peng Shuwen Wen! It almost folded him in half like origami! A beautiful dipping liver shot
the veteran. He went in there, threw a nice heavy 4-5 shot combo, stepped away, regrouped. Now he's looking for his next shot.
The boxing combinations. Down goes Ben Shuwin. And you'll need a cross standing up. A little Catalan go there for some ground and pound. Knee on belly. Ground and pound for the Filipino. Rene Catalan, house on fire.
He can spin into his arm bar. He almost, this could be it.
Could this be the first contender for the GoDaddy knockout of the night? Rene Catalan. Absolutely bludgeoning Ben Shuwin with the ground.
You could see Peng Shui Wen was starting to fade. He was a little bit slow to get up after that last ground and pound exchange. And then you could just see him. He wasn't in it anymore. Rene Catalan jumped on him, threw a nice little combo, stepped back, reassessed the situation. There's Peng Shui Wen, missed him with a big left hand, but came in with a right. That was beautifully done. Attempts the spinning back fist there, thought about it, didn't quite throw it, and then Catalan just unloads a little bit. Look at that, goes to the body, goes back up top, reassess the situation, jump back in. Once the ground and pound started, he didn't let up, and he ended Peng Shui Wen's night with the ground and pound. Didn't get the arm bar, but he came pretty close.
Olivia Coast dove in there to stop the onslaught from Rene Catalan. Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivia Coast, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 22 seconds in the second round. Or your winner, by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, Rene Catalan!
Rahadian in the gray trunks bounds out of his corner. Catalan in the red has the crowd behind him. First Filipino on tonight's show. A tentative start. Both men know each other well. They've studied each other's styles. Followed all the power. And there's a nice jab too from Rahadian. The leaner, ganglier of the two. The shorter, stockier Rene Catalan. The leader of the massive Catalan clan plows forward with a double hook.
Some beautiful hooks coming off Catalan. Nice attack to the body there. This is really going to be the difference for Catalan. You know, he's not used to having, you know, opponents that are this, like, as far as the striking capabilities of Catalan. It's explosive. And this is where Catalan really is going to shine, because he usually uses his wrestling as of late, where he's taking his opponents down and just beating on him. But now he's probably going to want to stay out of the ground area and keep this match on his feet.
One of these two men's magnificent streak will come to an end tonight. Big outside leg kick from Catalan. And a guy for the Russian champion. And he backs up Rahadian. There's the power of Rene Catalan. And he gets on the inside again. Stefan Rahadian failing to use his reach early on here, Dragon.
He's got to put that jab out there. Look at the way he's closing that distance.
Rene Catalan, house on fire, ties him up, presses him against the cage. Chance for the knees now. Turn around by Rahadian. Overhook on the left arm there by Rene Catalan. What a start for the ferocious Filipino.
And that's a gift for Rahadian. Catalan should not be clinching with Rahadian. He should separate and get back to throwing those hands. Because yeah, he was having a lot of success. This is where Rahadian wants to be. He likes to take down from the clinch. He likes to change levels and start to threaten at least a takedown here, because Catalan was beating him ruthlessly.
Catalan pressing Rahadian against the wire here. As Mitch said, Catalan should get some distance, work those hooks and those leg kicks again.
We've seen the wrestling of Catalan improve so much as of late. That's got to be thanks to the wrestling coach out there at the Catalan Fighting System. We've got high-level Wushu against some BJJ, but look at that takedown defense to turn it into offense from Catalan. He's got a guillotine.
Catalan trying to choke out Rahadian here in the first round. Listen to this punch.
Look at that defense from Rahardian. He went underneath the leg and basically just body slammed Catalan into the fan. Catalan's got to let go of this because there's a choke right there. Look at his shoulder being pressed up against the jugular of Catalan. There's a Von Flue choke.
This place is only about a quarter full. It's going to be a sellout in about an hour's time, and already it is deafening for Rene Catalan. Can you imagine the noise later on for Edward Flying, for Kevin Bellignon? It's going to be nuts in here.
Oh, man. The team Lakai is absolutely... Oh, nice transition from Catalan to get back up to his feet.
Filipino crowd right behind Rene Catalan. Catalan locking onto the leg of Rahardian. What an opening round for Rene Catalan. Gets a takedown. Rahardian tried to get back to his feet, rolls through. Sprawl out there from Catalan. Back to his feet. Rene Catalan having a superb opening round. Still, though, pressed up against Rahardian, not creating that space to work those strikes.
Yeah, and I think that's more of just Rahardian keeping tight in the clinch. Look how he's using his overhooks and underhooks just to stay close to Catalan. But Catalan has no fear to go to the ground with the submission specialist.
Let's see if Catalan getting those hooks working again now.
Looking for that leg kick again. That did a lot of damage. It even took the feet out from under Rahardian.
He take the legs from Rahardian. It's going to make it very hard for the Indonesian to shoot in and get a takedown. Uppercut there from Catalan. Telegraphed it off the lead hand. Rahardian tucking the chin as well he should, looking through the brack. Catalan trying to maintain control and center catch. Thought about the jab too. Final seconds of the opening round. What has been an absolute cracker for the Philippines, Rene Catalan. Where are you watching live on Twitter, live on Facebook, live on the One Super app? It's Rene Kings, our prelim show from the Mall of Asia Arena in Manila.
Look at these leg kicks. Look how he finishes each combination with a low kick, and he's attacking that lower leg. I like that. Look at this. Rahardian went for the outside trip, and beautifully done counter by Catalan to change direction and put Rahardian on his back. Huge round for the Filipino, Rene Catalan.
We are told that there is a massive line snaking its way around the arena outside. It is the hottest chicken in Manila tonight, inside the massive Mall of Asia Arena. For one championship reign of kings, we are expecting a sellout. And it's already deafening in here for Rene Catalan. I can't imagine what it will be like for Flying and Bellignon later on tonight. Also Joshua Pascio.
All right, ready? Ready?
Can Catalan get the first win for Team Philippines? Second round set for three. First was a corker. What does Rahardian need to do here, Mitch?
Rahardian, first of all, needs to utilize that jab. Change levels and then look for a double leg. He doesn't want to stand and, you know, have the Rene Catalan looking down on him like this, because he's a wushu world champion. He has competed hundreds of times in the stand-up arts. So Rahardian's got to get this match quickly to the ground and not stand at range, especially at kicking range of Catalan.
Stefan Rahardian has never experienced defeat.
But you can't just shoot like that on Catalan, man. You've got to put together some punches first. Make him think you're going to strike and then change levels to go for that double leg.
Looking for the underhook on that left there. Stefan Rahardian, oh, rips the left hand into the liver. Does Rene Catalan. Rahardian puts him against the cage. A real joust in the clinch up here. Catalan, so tremendously strong, like a little ox. He just shrugs off Rahardian. Watch for the leg kicks now. Watch for the hooks off Catalan. There's the hook. Smack bang on the kisser. And Rahardian getting a quick count of his teeth. The takedown defense there from Catalan.
A beautiful defensive turn into offense in that takedown from Raharjian. Raharjian's got to be very careful on his feet. The way Catalan is changing levels and coming up with that big hook.
Rene Catalan having the performance of a lifetime so far. What's he looking for here, Dragon?
He tried to turn the corner real quick, but Raharjian was too wise to it. He knew how to settle down the hips. Now he's going to try to pass the guard, but Catalan closes the guard. This is where Raharjian wanted to be.
Raharjian inside the guard of Catalan as we approach the halfway mark of his tremendous bout.
This match is going to say a lot about Raharjian, you know? This is the first time he's really been put and hit with a lot of big shots. You know, we're used to seeing him just dominate opponents and outwork them on the ground. But Catalan is very slick on his own. Look at him striking from the back.
Catalan working off his back. Raharjian looking to pass to the left side of the body. Couldn't get there. Looks to go to side control. Catalan keeps him inside the guard. Nice work from the Filipino. Tracks an elbow to the collarbone of the Indonesian. I'm just so impressed by Rene Catalan so far here tonight, Mitch.
Yeah, he was maintaining guard pretty well, but Raharjian stepped over one leg, and now he's in half guard. So I'd like to see, you know, Catalan take that left arm and start to get underneath the right arm there. There you go. That's what he's trying to do. Almost got it, but Raharjian knows exactly what Catalan's trying to do, so he's going to keep his arm nice and tight. And as long as Catalan can't get that underhook on that left side, Rahardian's going to be able to flatten him out and just kind of pound on him, but he's got to be active.
Raharjian did predict a second round finish by a rear naked choke. Catalan predicted a finish by a ground and pound. 90 seconds remaining, second round of three. First round was a beauty from Rene Catalan. Locking up the left arm over Raharjian. Catalan posturing up for the ground and pound. Now the Indonesian gets a little bit of posture. Rakes a forearm across the forehead. Looks to pass again. Catalan not letting him go to the side. Looks to pass once more here. And Catalan keeps him in half guard.
Yeah, Catalan's doing a good job of just kind of following Raharjian around as Raharjian's trying to change directions and trying to pass the guard of Catalan. Catalan's doing a good job just by keeping that leg up. Just as I said that, Raharjian passes into side control. And Catalan's pretty explosive, so he might be able to power his way out of this.
Dominant position now for Raharjian. Can he make good use of it? 30 seconds remains. Elbow to the side of the head there from Catalan. Knee from Raharjian takes the back. Slips over the top though. What can he look for here, Mitch?
Ah, see, that's the explosion that I was talking about. Right as Raharjian tried to get into mount, Catalan bridged out and very nicely got on top. Raharjian's continuing the pressure. Uh-oh. Nice change of levels there from Raharjian, but Catalan was wise to it.
Beautiful knee there from Catalan. Raharjian puts him against the wire. Dicks to the body. There's two rounds down, one to go.
Look at this. Beautifully done. Right on the button. Wobbled back Raharjian. I don't think Rahardian's ever been hit that hard. Nice takedown defense there, but he's trying to punch rather than controlling the position. You can see him. Look at this. Beautifully done hip toss into it. Uchimata had the overhook through his leg in between, and a beautiful, again, turning his defense into offense from Catalan.
And it's all part of one championship reign of King's Fun. From Manila, the Philippines, it's our prelim show. As we tick down towards a triple main event tonight, including the return, the comeback of the legend, Enzo Gracie, Shannon Ruichai versus Shinya Aoki. And Martin Nguyen looks to become the sport's first ever simultaneous three-division champion against Kevin Bellignon for the interim bantamweight strap. Third and final round. Wherever you're watching live, on Facebook Live, on Twitter Live, on the One Super app, I hope you're enjoying all this magnificent martial arts action.
Catalan to set up that hook again. That's the weapon that's been landing him over and over again. Raharjian's dropping that right hand a little bit, leaving his chin exposed, and Catalan is wise to him. He's throwing that big left hook. He's changing levels and then coming up really quickly.
Rahardian just loosening the arms, the long arms. He's got to use them, use the range, use the reach, and keep Catalan at bay.
But when he is, when his punching range is essentially Catalan's kicking range. So I'd like to see Catalan start throwing those leg kicks, throwing a little bit of the 1-2, boom, going down low with that leg kick again.
Catalan switching stances, looking cagey here, the veteran. And referee Olivier Coast says, you've got to engage. Catalan edges forward. Left hand cocked and ready to come down the center corridor or to hook. Shakes it off as Catalan resets, goes back to orthodox stance now. There's the outside leg kick. Hits that common peroneal nerve just above the knee.
It's a good weapon for him. You can see Rahardian is not checking it. He's not defending it. He's not trying to catch it and go for a takedown. That leg kick is there all day. Catalan should just keep going back to it until Rahardian changes something.
Left hook there from Rahardian. Inside leg kick. Nice little step across there from Catalan. Fake from Catalan. Drifts out of the way. Looking very confident here, Rene Catalan sprawls out, defends the takedown attempt.
See, this distance is perfect for Catalan. He's still inside kicking range, and Rahardian's not setting up that takedown. He's just shooting in at him, and Catalan has proven so far that he can sprawl heavy onto Rahardian and just pop back up.
Leg kick connecting, Catalan fires an uppercut and a hook both off the lead hand. If one of these two men really puts the foot down, they could go kleptomaniac and steal it. Outside leg kick to a left hook combination there from Catalan.
I don't know if Rahardian realizes he is halfway through the third and final round of this match, and Catalan might be ahead on the judges' scorecards here.
Big Mike from Bali MMA in the corner of Rahardian, Italian stepper to shoot in. They want their man to go, they want him to go now. Body shot from Catalan. They tango, back against the cage. Chance for the knees here for Rene Catalan.
Hook landed again, Michael. So he goes, hey, I'd like to see him put together a combination. Go hook, boom, low kick.
Back to center cage, 2 minutes remaining in what has been a gripping affair. Catalan trying to time everything once again, lands the hook. It's been prime weapon for Rene Catalan. And there's another left hook. Smack bang the jaw of Stefan Rahardian. He has outstruck Rahardian the entire contest. Overhand right to a left hook. Rahardian's got to start producing now, Mitch. Time is running out for the Indonesian.
Yeah, he's got about 90 seconds to change the tide of this match, and he might only be able to do it with a submission here, because Catalan is picking him apart on the feet.
Catalan has done everything right. Left hook to an outside thigh kick. Beautiful combination work from the Filipino.
So you can't back up like this. You can see immediately, as soon as Catalan starts to even faint, for like he's gonna come forward, Rahardian backs up with his chin up in the air. This is gonna be either a valuable lesson for him or a huge surprise that's gonna diminish his confidence.
I tell you what, Mitch, if Catalan gets the win here tonight, it would be considered a major upset by many pundits. And it would bring the house down here in Manila.
I like how Catalan's switching to southpaw so that he can set up maybe a big right hand, because that left hand, or a big left hand rather, because that left hand has been landing all night.
Look to shoot in for a double leg, and again, Catalan saw it coming up, cracks away to that lead fly. Left hook outside leg kick, bread and butter combination for Rene Catalan. Now they tango against the cage. 20 seconds to go. Let's see what Rahardian has left in his bag of tricks. Left hook backs him off. It's been another solid round for Rene Catalan. The left hooks, the outside leg kicks. The Filipinos here inside the Ball of Asia Arena believe their man has done it. He pumps a fist in the air, does Rene Catalan, as he just pulled off an upset, as he just stopped one of the best streaks in one championship.
Wow, what a performance by Rene Catalan. Look at this. just waits his time. That was a very effective low kick from Rahardian. I would have liked to see him using that much earlier. But again, as soon as Rene starts to move back, you can see just the uncomfortableness of the pressure and how Rahardian is responding to it by his chin popping up in the air like that. And again, he's landed with that left hand all night. Great performance by Rene Catalan.
Are we going to have the first win for Team Philippines here tonight? Let's go to Dominic Lau and find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Rene Catalan.
The submission wizardry of Naito. As we saw against Alex Silva when he won the title, Naito striking certainly improved. Naito jabbing. Catalan taking his time. A low single leg attempt there. Sakuraba style from Naito.
Good heavy sprawl from Catalan. This first takedown attempt is going to tell us a lot. Watch Nobita try to take that leg. He still has his hands clasped. Now watch him turn that corner. Catalan cannot let his leg get sucked in, because that's what he was going to do. He's going to try to lace that leg, and now the boa constrictor goes to work. Watch him slowly start to inch up that body. Good little wizard defense there from Catalan.
This is always the big question. How does a Wushu world champion defend against a man of the grappling skills of Yoshitaka Naito?
I like that roll through he did to get that position. Now he's got Catalan back up against the fence. Catalan has to keep working. He cannot let Nobita suck him into this position. He's got to get that leg free. He's got to start pushing that head down. He's got to work his way back up that wall or the cage.
Catalan will need to find a way back to his feet where he can get off those wushu strikes he's renowned for. The Filipino comes in on a five-match tear. And what five victories they have been. But he doesn't do it from here, Catalan. This is not comfort for Catalan. This is Naitoville. This is Naito territory. And this is what you said, Mitch. He grinds away. He breaks you down methodically, systematically, until you can't take any more. He snaps on a sub and he chokes you out.
Good job from Catalan, though, to get back up. He's almost back up, but see what Nobita does is he uses his legs like their arms. He's always trying to grab your legs and suck them back in. That's the second time he's rolled through like that. But good job from Catalan. He's got to push the head away. He's got to sprawl out heavy. He's got to get his legs away from the legs of Nobita, because that's what he's going to keep doing. He's going to keep trying to get control of one leg, lace it over with his leg, and then slowly start to put Catalan on his back.
Single leg locked on here from Naito, the self-confessed comic book geek. You know, you walk past Naito on the street and the last thing you'd think the man is a former world champion.
Yeah, one of the most dangerous men on the planet. Looks like he's from a cartoon.
Looks like my accountant. Right hand there from Catalan, top position for the Filipino. Needs to get the strikes off, needs to damage Yoshitaka Naito. Good strikes to the top of the head there from Catalan. He's a four-time Wushu world champion.
He's got to hurt him in these positions. He's got to make Naito second guess getting this close to him. He's got to try to frame off that head, create a little bit of space, because that body lock is going to stay nice and tight. He can get that space, and he can start to keep delivering those shots.
Some good shots off the right hand between the eyes of Naito. Catalan doing damage, pushing the head down.
He's trying to create that space. He's got to get that leg free, which he almost did. Now he's still got that wizard. That's keeping him controlled.
Oh, knee there from Catalan. He's cut him. Naito's bleeding. Catalan with the hammer fist strikes. Going after it now. Here comes Rene Catalan. The hammer fist strikes on Naito. He's doing the damage here in the first round.
The trophy model is doing a great job of controlling his posture with that wizard. He's consistently pushing the head down and keeping Naito away, but he's got to keep working on it.
Oh, my word. Have a look at that. Here come the heavy hooks again. Those car batteries of hands raining down the punishments on Naito. Kipching on top of it, he may stop it soon. Catalan is just shellacking the former world champion. Is it going to go six in a row for Catalan? The damage, the hammer fist, like a madman raining down blows on Naito. Naito not defending. Catalan unloading. Naito taking more shots than an alcoholic. How many more can he take? His cut wide open. Boom, again with the left hand goes Catalan. Now maybe the elbow's gonna come down.
Catalan's hurt him.
Oh, Naito's in trouble. He is damaged good. It's over. It's 6 weeks in a row. The four-time Wushu world champion has just beaten the former one strawweight world champion.
Wow, Rene Catalan might have just earned his way to his first world title shot over a huge first round victory over the former champion. Look at this wrestling defense. He was all over it. And then once he had Naito hurt, he just kept delivering the shots until referee Kim Chang jumped in to call a halt to it.
That one brought to you by Myanmar Gannad Advertising. And you know what, Mitch, for all the hype in one championships, Filipinos around the likes of Palayang and Balugon and Pacio and Eustaquio from Team Lakai, this man is riding a six-match winning streak, and he just destroyed Naito. We've never seen anyone destroy Naito like that. Never. Incredible. Let's go to Tom Lau.
To present the medal for this match, we have the managing director from Myanmar Gannad Advertising, Mr. Kenson Gan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kim Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 32 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Rene Catalan!
Bokang Masunyane and Ryuto Sawada. Masunyane bounding out of his corner. Over with a jab at a southpaw stance, switches to orthodox now, drops it down to the bread basket. Looks for the inside leg, Masunyane. Sawada, that bright red hair, getting into the Christmas spirit, I suppose. Better high kick. Masunyane comes in with very big credentials, very highly rated. Number one fly in South Africa. Good right hand there from Sawada. Just copped a finger to the eye.
Neutral corner.
As you said, Mitch, has been so excited all week, Bokang Masunyane, to be here in one championship on the biggest martial arts stage on the planet.
Yeah, this is his first time competing outside of South Africa, and he really wants to make the most of it. You can see Masunyane came in, changed levels, but they just clashed heads right there. It was kind of on the bridge of the nose, and a little bit on the upper eye, so possibly no cut, hopefully no damage was inflicted into Sawada. Nothing that's gonna prevent him from continuing on this matchup. You can see Masunyane immediately started switching stances, giving Sawada a lot of different looks. They're taking a very close look at Sawada's eye, and it looks like he's ready to go. It looks like he is good, but I think the referee and the doctor says, yep, he's good to go, and looks like we're gonna get back at it.
Overwhelming amount of fans tipped Sawada for the win tonight on One Fantasy, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game. Download it now on the One Super app. 70% saying Sawada, 30% for Bokang Masunyane on debut. Masunyane looking for a sidekick. Jump ball in the hand there from the South African. Gets backed up with a right hand from Sawada. Two punch combination from the Japanese.
Sawada doesn't seem too fazed by the movement of Bokang Masunyane, but now he's inside that clinch. Now we're going to expect Bokang to continually attack. He doesn't just go for one takedown. He likes a lot. That's a beautiful Uchimata, which is that he got the overhook, tried to get that foot inside the legs and throw him over the hip. Nice little balance displayed by Masunyane.
Masunyane continually switching stance between southpaw and orthodox here. Jabs out of orthodox, switches to southpaw, back to orthodox. Uppercuts from Sawada. Another hip toss takedown there, but Masunyane in
ends up on top. Now takes the back of the Japanese athlete.
Wow, that's the second time Sawada's gone for that Uchimata, but beautiful hips displayed by Masunyane as he was able to float over. That's just decades of wrestling experience to have that kind of balance and to maintain that position. That was beautifully done by Masunyane. Now he's nice and tight, guys, the back. I'd expect Sawada to swing that right arm over and go chest to chest and look to stand back up.
Sawada in front of his corner here, giving him instructions. Masunyane still has the back of the Japanese athlete, tries to cork up that outside right thigh. There's one to this sciatic nerve of Sawada. How does Sawada get out of this predicament, Dragon?
Beautifully done. Look at that control. This is what he's done in all six of his victories. He just outworks, outcontrols people. Now, you guys got to keep in mind, Sawada is a wrestler. He's a high-level BJJ purple belt, currently riding a six-win streak, and he's just able to, you know, he's got seven submission victories, so he knows what to do, but this is just being outclassed in the wrestling department by a high-level grappler.
He's continued to rain down on that right thigh and hamstring area of Sawada. The crowd thoroughly entertained so far. Massive crowd inside the Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia for the last one championship show of the year.
You can see Sawada's doing a good, you can see him doing all the right things as far as defense is concerned, trying to separate the hands, trying to turn to go chest to chest. But he's just keeping such a tight grip, it's hard to break that grip. You can see him, I think he's looking for a Kimura. It's hard to see on this side, but if he's able to take that Kimura, he might be able to separate the hands and use it to spin.
125 remains, first round of three, still with the knees off the left leg here, Masunyane. Beautiful roll through there, for Sawada. Masunyane continues to score with his knees, goes back to the outside right thigh. There's another attempt at a roll from Sawada. Masunyane picks him up, tries to slam him down. Didn't quite have the effect that South Africa was looking for.
But he is able to control Sawada. Look at this, there's no place for him to go. He is able to dictate exactly where he wants this match to take place. And right now, it is to have that body lock. And there is nothing Sawada can do to separate this. He's trying a lot of rolls. He's trying to create some distance and some space. But these knees are going to build up over time, and I think these knees are going to pay dividends if we hit the later rounds of this one.
And plenty of action in this opening round. Presented coming from Bokang Masunyane of South Africa. Just going to town on that left leg, now trying to knee the face of Sawada. Masunyane's had his back for a long, long time. Reverse elbow there from Sawada. Just above the ear of the South African. Good work from Sawada. What a first round to kick off one championship. Mark of greatness from Malaysia.
We got to see a lot of different looks, but it was the grappling. Here is a beautiful little hand combination with a nice little uppercut. And there you got to see Bokang shoot in, get that clinch, but then a beautiful hip throw, the Uchimata by Sawada. But then that float over was beautifully done. And then this was how he spent the second half of that round. And just a lot of top control, just beautifully done by Masunyane. And I do have to correct myself. Big thank you to James Gorder, who did correct me, and he said that actually Masunyane's bout, his last bout was in Japan, so all of his bouts have not been just in South Africa. He does have some international exposure, so he's showing us a lot of different things right now, but we are seeing him develop that ground strategy. Just see, when he gets that lock on you, there's no place for him to go.
Second round of three, Bokang Masunyane of South Africa on one championship debut against Ryuto Sawada from Japan. Jab two there from Masunyane. We saw him switch between southpaw and orthodox in the first. He's doing so again here in the second. Always keeping Sawada guessing.
This is what Sawada's got to do. He's got to avoid the clinch, keep the distance, utilize that jab. But he's got to be a little bit nervous now, a little bit tentative of really letting things go, because he doesn't want Masunyane to get close, to get that body lock on him again, because he was having his way with him.
Masunyane switching again, thrusts out the jab. Now he's in southpaw stance, changes levels momentarily. Sawada gets out of the way of the high kick. Masunyane didn't turn the hips in, didn't pivot on the support foot. Uppercut there from the South African. Sawada tries to return the favor. Jab two to a three hook there from Sawada. Jumping knee, backs him off with a short popping right. Intriguing matchup this one. Well, Masunyane changed levels. Well, rolled the hand and held the back again. Will he throw those knees? Yes, he does. Straight back.
And went with a head kick. The second time he went with a fake and landed an uppercut. It sets up a lot of different options for Masunyane. But again, we're back exactly where he spent pretty much the entire first half of this, or the second half of the first round. Just him having that body lock, getting nice and tight. I'd like to see him attack the legs now. Start dropping those legs in, pull the legs, pull the hips away from the circle wall, and start to lay in a little bit of ground and pound. Now he's got that seatbelt position here. That's going to give you, exactly, that's going to give Sawada a chance to peel it off and get up top.
Here comes Sawada with the hands now. Jab two, three there from Sawada. Throws the uppercut, almost took out the ring box. Goes the belly button through the back. And Masunyane says, you can't hurt me with that. You've got to do better. Jab there from the South African, switches to southpaw. Double jab on the way in, no left cross for company. Back to orthodox, sticks him with a jab.
I like that straight right hand, whether he's going to the body or he's going to the head. It's doing a lot of good work. Touch it up, and there he goes again. Trying that hip toss.
Say Uchimata, you love Say Uchimata. Say it again, call it what it is.
Only it for you, he didn't land it. He attempted it. It was like an Uchi, it was just half of it. He didn't quite get it.
He was missing the motto, is that what you're saying? Got the back again here of Sawada. Really go to town on that leg. There it is. You knew it was coming. Those knees in the outside right thigh. Scoops out the support leg there.
I like that move, how he swept out that leg. Ah, there's just so much control. Just able to utilize just that body lock to do really whatever he wants. He hasn't really advanced anything from it. Oh, nice job by triangling the legs. He's got to try to suck the hips away and get into a more dominant position. You can see he's utilizing the body lock to kind of control Sawada, but he's not able to advance anything. He's not able to use it to, you know, establish any dominant position.
Okay, Masunyane showing more control in an episode of Get Smart. Inside the guard here of Sawada. Sawada controlling the South African's posture. Here's what the ground and pounder, Masunyane raining down on him. Little shoulder thrust there from Masunyane.
Head center.
Gets a left hand off there. Some right hand in orbital.
Head center.
Under a minute remaining. Second round of three. Under this global rule set of mixed martial arts, we are scoring as an overall match, not round by round.
See him in top position. Now he's utilizing a lot of ground and pound. I like that elbow over the top. Keeping Sawada on his back. He's not really trying to pass. We've seen this in the past from Masunyane. He likes to sit in the guard and beat on people.
30 seconds left in the second round.
Sawada, feet on hips here from the Japanese with the flaming red hair tonight. Masunyane trying to break free, trying to posture up, and you see that right arm just holding him down, controlling the South African posture. We are going to go to the towels again here. And we are going to go into deep water. Folks, don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at One Championship.
Look at this. You can see it. You can see it. Once he gets that underhook, that's exactly what Masunyane wants to do. You can see that Sawada overhooks that arm, tries to get the leg in between the legs of Masunyane, and then he tries to throw the Uchimata, but it's those hips of Masunyane. He's able to just control his balance so well. He never lands on his back. This is a very interesting matchup. We get to see a lot of top work. This time, Masunyane was able to get into the guard of Sawada and land some heavy elbows, lands a little bit of ground and pound, not doing significant work as far as the ground control is concerned, so meaning that he's not advancing his position, but he is able to land some strikes from that top position with the elbows. Let's see what the third stanza has in store for us.
Sold out inside the Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, for the last one championship show of the year. And what a way to kick it off here with Ryuto Sawada and Bokang Masunyane.
The hands of Sawada are nice, man. He's got clean, crisp boxing style. He just managed to keep things on his feet, and he could really show us something.
Masunyane with the acrobatics there, oohs and ahs, and gnashing of teeth from this big audience.
Yeah, if you check out his Instagram, this guy is an acrobat to the fullest extent. Loves the flips, love the acrobatics. He's trying to put on a show for us here tonight. But it's the timing of Sawada. You can see he waits. You can just see the striking superiority coming from Sawada.
Which was the reason for Masunyane continually switching stance, doing it so often.
But it also sets up a single leg, so once he switches to southpaw, that single leg is a lot closer, that lead leg right there. But he likes to change things up. He likes to give Sawada a different look because Sawada's kind of lighting him up on the feet.
Sawada's hands. Right hand connected to the control of Masunyane. Masunyane flicks out a jab, drifts back to center circle, trying to press Sawada back. Sawada misses with a hook, Masunyane drives him against the wall.
See, he likes to do the body lock clinch once he's in orthodox, but when he's in southpaw, that single leg is a lot easily there, is easily available. But now we're back to that body lock position, nice and tight for Masunyane.
In all three rounds. Now Masunyane on top, inside the guard of Sawada. 3:15 remain.
He's just got such good top control. His balance is so good. Every time Sawada tries to roll through, a lot of people would not be able to hold on to him the way that Masunyane does. But this guy is a high-level wrestler, and we're seeing why he's undefeated.
Sawada, one of two Japanese athletes on tonight's card earlier on tonight, taking Naito, getting a win over Rui Botello in a one Super Series Muay Thai clash. And the Japanese go 2-0 to win the year in one championship. Okay, Masunyane, the only South African on tonight's card. The only South African, I dare say, in one championship.
I know I'm going to get called out for this, but I think he... Yeah, I think he might be the only one we got.
And doing a superb job on debut, Bokang Masunyane, entertaining the fans. Ball through from Sawada. Still Masunyane has the Japanese athletes back.
He's kind of looking just to hold on. You can see he's not really trying to advance his position. He's not really trying to get the hooks in. He's just holding on to the back of Sawada and really just controlling him. I'd like to see him maybe establish that seatbelt position, get those hooks in, but you can just see, like, the BJJ of Sawada is just a little bit better, and once he does try to move beyond this body lock, Sawada is able to escape, but the wrestling is far superior out of Bokang Masunyane.
Masunyane controlling Ryuto Sawada of Japan with 90 seconds on the clock. Impressive debut so far for the South African back to throw most corporate need to the outside front. And there's one to the rear section. Couple of hands coming in now from Masunyane. Good outside five. And again, they need the outside five from Masunyane.
Man, the frustration that Sawada must be feeling just to have this guy on your back, not giving you any space, not giving you any opportunities, and really shutting down all your offense, especially when you're having success on your feet and you're touching him up with those punches.
South Africa always been a very successful kickboxing nation. He never forget my boy.
Danny Sackett's
got some good. Georgia Gallagoda. Down the drive, Blue Jack. And this goes on. The mixed martial art, this man, Bokang Masunyane, trying to signal to the watching world in South Africa, has arrived on the main stage, on the biggest stage. Sawada with a left hook. Good right hand. Just on the panel behind the goal from the Japanese warrior. On the inside, in the phone booth, so to speak. Uppercut to a left hook there from Masunyane. Final 10 seconds.
Going.
It looks like we're going down to the judges here in Kuala Lumpur. And wherever you're watching, folks, in over 140 countries around the world, do you score it for Ryuto Sawada or do you give it to Bokang Masunyane?
We got to see a lot of good handiwork coming from Sawada. He was able to put up punches together, showcase some beautiful combinations. There's a nice stiff jab by Sawada, but he was ultimately outworked on the ground in almost every single area. It was that body lock by Masunyane. Every place he tried to go, you had that seatbelt wrapped around you. There's nothing you could do to get it off you. He was trying to get rid of the hands, couldn't get him off his back, but just some more acrobatics coming from Masunyane as he celebrates what he thinks is another victory to take him to 7-0.
Okay, let's go to Tom Lau and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Bokang.